Everyone knows the children are out there to have fun and enjoy their youthful years. They must explore the world by themselves ever since they learn to speak and think. But how will you live your life as a child if you have a hard time coping up with your environment? It happened to her so long ago. It was her 7th birthday. She never experienced celebrating any of it. Her parents were too busy not to see each other's faults, so they never knew how much she was longing for their love and care. Anyway, back to her story, it was her worst birthday. She was playing with her toys in her room, and as usual, she heard her mom and dad exchanging hurtful words. She got used to it, since there were no days that passed that they did not yell at each other. But this time, they reached their limitation. Without a word to mouth, she was shocked to see her dad packing up his things.
Dad, this baby come inside.
Ayun lang naman yung
No, maybe we're just having a little misunderstanding.
But where are you going, Dad? Don't leave us alone here.
Somewhere. There. I don't know.
But how about me? Am I gonna leave you alone, Dad?
No, maybe I just need a little time to think about it. To think about everything.
Dad!
Would you like to come with me?
How about mom?
He went back to packing up his things as if he heard nothing. She called his name again, but he didn't respond. Tears were falling, but he didn't care. For the very last time, he said his last words and left her with her mom. The town was so empty. She started to feel like she lost her life. Her dad was always there for her since she opened her eyes in reality. Then, there he was. And he was devastated.
She was really glad to hear that.
Hey, you want to hear my sad story?
Sure, what is it?
My dad left me and my mom.
Don't worry, I'm sure he'll come back.
Just eat.
They never let Emily have even a seat once. They never wanted her to go out and make friends. She lived her whole life in silence. There were two persons only who knew she existed. She got tired and sick of it. Until one day, Emily saw someone sitting on her bed. She was surprised to find her there and wondered who it was. Emily had to meet her. She was so eager to have friends. She looked up to Emily and talked to her.
They had a great time playing dolls. They laughed together and shared each other's thoughts. As time had passed unnoticeably, she became Emily's friend, her very best friend. Yes, they became that intimate, without knowing exactly her name. She treated her as her sibling and called her sis. It seemed that she liked it. She enjoyed being in her company. With her, Emily felt no pain. She started to forget the painful memories that happened, especially on her 7th birthday.
It felt like months had passed. She realized that she hadn't seen her mom. She didn't even hear her sweet voice. She went out of her room and saw a different world, a world she did not live with. Everything was new. She guessed she had rejoiced too much for having the first companion. Then she saw her mom. She looked better compared to the last day she saw her. Her face was bright and she had smiles. Then she noticed everything was different.
Her house was full of colors, and there were two children, a girl who seemed to be a 14-year-old and a baby boy who aged like 5. She started to think who they were. Then, she saw a man entering their house. It was their dad. She knew it. He would come back for her. She ran so fast to him. She wanted to kiss him, hug him, everything. But she passed through him. She could not touch him. She started to get puzzled. What was happening to her? She shouted as loud as she could, but it seemed that no one heard her. She began to cry and got tired.
Do you still remember your 7th birthday? I was almost there! Just stop! I'm sorry, Emily, but I think you have too. There's no point, okay? Just leave me alone! I see nothing but the truth, Emily. The reason why you can communicate with them is you're dead now. That's not true! That's not what happened! You were found dead after your birthday.
And now he came back. I think it's time to go.
Wait, what is it, Emily?
I'm just wondering who you are. I mean, you waited for me until my dad came.
You were named after me. I was your mom's mom. When I said I'll never let you go, when all those shadows on my